Murtoa and the Stick Shed. Rain is central to the story of Murtoa, and the Stick Shed signifies a part of this story. A story that depicts both the impact of World War II on Australia's trade and export industry and the transformation of grain haulage in Australia. Murtoa is a proud wheatbelt town that was settled in 1872 with Lake Mama as the centrepiece and the railways central to trade and employment. The Stick Shed is a grain storage facility known as Murtoa No. 1 Grain Store. It was built over 4 months between September 1941 and January 1942 and filled with grain within 6 months of construction. It was the first emergency bulk wheat storage shed built in Victoria and is the only remaining shed of its type in Australia. The Stick Shed covers 4 acres under roof and measures 265 metres long, 60 metres wide and almost 20 metres high at its apex. The size and scale of the Stick Shed reflects the massive growth of the wheat industry and the need for mass distribution, bulk grain handling and storage facilities for Australia's oldest agricultural crop. Murtoa was selected as the site for the Stick Shed as it was located within a major wheat cropping area and adjacent to the main railway line between Melbourne and Adelaide. It was also at the confluence of an additional branch line connecting the northern wheat areas of the Mallee via Hopetoun. The working section of the present-day GrainCorp Murtoa Grain Receival Centre can hold up to 400,000 tonnes of grain and is the largest inland receival centre in Australia. Why the Stick Shed was built? The story of Murtoa and the Stick Shed is one inextricably linked to grain. There was a wheat glut in Australia beginning in the late 1930s. The main overseas wheat export market was Great Britain and Western Europe, which rapidly decreased due to a shift in their trading partners and restricted shipping with the commencement of World War II in 1939. Asia became the new target market in the interim as part of the Colombo Plan. With trade restricted due to the war, grain excess was rapidly stockpiling. In 1939-40, a good wheat crop and a heavily reduced export trade due to World War II led to grain stockpiling and a shortage of storage facilities. This prompted the Australian Wheat Board to design and build the first large bulk storages in Western Australia. They were referred to as bulkheads originally, then commonly known as emergency wheat storage sheds. Victorian wheat storages, including the many concrete bulk silos built in the 1930s, filled up. Countless railway sidings around Australia began to overflow with bagged wheat brought in directly from farms. Finally, the potentially large 1941-2 Victorian crop was looming, so it became critical that an immediate solution to this massive problem was found in Victoria. The Victorian Grain Elevators Board decided, despite much opposition from many quarters involved in bag handling, to construct the first Victorian shed at the important railway site of Murtoa. The Stick Shed construction. In 1941, the Grain Elevators Board commissioned the sheds based on earlier designs in Western Australia for the protection of bulk wheat stored at ground level using roofing iron and outwardly sloped walls. The shed as designed was approximately 265 metres long, 60 metres wide, 19 metres high at the hip, and held 3.5 million bushels, or about 92,500 tonnes of wheat. Green Brothers, contractors of Bendigo, undertook construction on this site in September 1941. Much of the building was constructed with little mechanical aid and a limited workforce due to the war. A steel shortage meant the shed was built largely from readily available timber, some 560, 56 rows of 10, unmilled mountain ash poles erected into the auger dug footings in the ground. Concrete was manually poured around the footings. Galvanised hoop iron was used in most structural joints. This adapted solution was due to problems with differing pole sizes and the expected shrinkage, warping and twisting of unseasoned hardwood. This contributed to the building's capacity to survive for more than 75 years, as it gave the structure the ability to move and shift due to internal usage stresses and high winds without collapsing. There is over 150 tonnes of corrugated iron on the roof, which covers 16,000 square metres of land. The roof angle was sloped to reflect the same angle a pile of wheat forms naturally. This has a rainfall runoff of about 35 megalitres of water per annum. Stick sheds built after Murtoa in Victoria had tin floors, which was the main variation from this first shed built with 16,000 square metres of concrete flooring. The stick shed incorporated filling and emptying systems and had its own dedicated external steam engine to drive it all. It was located on the main Adelaide to Melbourne railway line. To service these storage sheds, a new railway siding called Marmalake was built in 1941 and operated as a staff-locked loop siding. An independent connection between Murtoa and Marmalake was provided in December 1950. That allowed shunting to occur without interruption by mainline trains. In this era, grain was mostly transported by rail, either in bulk or in sewn jute bags of 3 bushels capacity, about 180 pounds in weight. Bulk deliveries of grain by train were distributed through the stick shed via an elevator and a central conveyor running high along the centre of the shed. Braced internal timber bulkheads on either side of the shed took the lateral thrust of the wheat, and a conveyor at ground level outside the south bulkhead took wheat back to the elevator for transport elsewhere by rail again. Wheat was transferred to this conveyor using various means, including conveyors and wheat throwers. By 1947, an additional hopper at the east end allowed local deliveries of wheat in bags or in bulk, which connected by an elevator to the filling conveyor. Times have changed. Local heritage versus local economics. The Murtoa No. 1 grain storage started life as a practical structure, an emergency grain store, the first of its type, and was followed a year later by the larger Murtoa No. 2 grain store. Over the next 30 years, the shed slowly began to deteriorate, requiring increasing maintenance. Wheat buyer demands forced grain handlers to adapt to new measures. Buyers wanted more options of grades and types, so the practice of stockpiling wheat on the ground using bunkers became the common practice. It could be readily segregated into all classes and quality, and the demand for fair average quality wheat from the massive bulkheads was sliding into the past. The need for these massive grain stores diminished, and the Murtoa No. 2 grain store was demolished in 1975. The No. 1 grain store, the last stick shed used in Australia, also became surplus to the wheat industry's needs in 1989 and was emptied for the last time by the Grains Elevator Board in 1990 when the last of its contents, 30,000 tonnes, were railed away. The demand for bunker land was increasing and the Murtoa Grains Elevator Board site was stretched. The debate grew louder throughout the region around whether the Murtoa No. 1 grain storage should be pulled down to make way for efficient grain bulk handling on the rail or kept as an important historical structure. A local group lobbied to keep the structure as part of the region's heritage, but this was deemed contrary to economic progress in bulk grain management. It was added to the Victorian Heritage Register in 1990. The stick shed moving forward. Eventually, as time passed, a compromise was reached between local economic progress and maintaining tangible heritage. The local interest groups managed to gain funds for urgent repairs to the deteriorating building. Slowly, momentum increased, and the stick shed gained recognition as a heritage building that could function within an active and regionally important grain storage facility. The stick shed, as you see it today, remains fully protected. And it was added to the Australian Heritage List in 2014 as entry number 101. The National Trust was the prime instigator, assisted by Heritage Victoria and supported by the Yarriambiack Shire Council. This is recognition of a significant part of Australia's history associated with the wheat industry and the impact of World War II on the home front. The Stick Shed Committee of Management was formed under the Government of Victoria's Department of Environment, Land, Water and Planning in 2016. And as a result, the Stick Shed was able to be managed locally and open to the public more often with the support of the Murtoa Lions Club volunteers. The focus of the committee is investment in the repair of the building, sustaining the structure as part of the region's important grain history, and opening the Stick Shed to the public. The Stick Shed is now a major tourism attraction in the Wimmera. Your visit to the Stick Shed supports the protection of this piece of Australia's heritage for future generations. Be sure to spread the word about Murtoa's Stick Shed.